So what's holding you back from getting a penile implant? Dr. Kent DeLay here, board certified urologist practicing in South Carolina. I use this channel to educate my audience on issues relevant to urology and men's health. If you enjoy what you see here, please like and subscribe and turn on notifications so that you can see future content as it is released. So today I want to review what men see as some of the biggest barriers to getting a penile implant. But first, what is a penile implant? A penile implant is a hydraulic device which is implanted as part of an outpatient procedure which allows for the restoration of a man's erections when other options such as oral medications or penile injections haven't been effective or have not met the man's needs. These devices have been around for more than 40 years and provide consistent, reliable erections. Let's review what men see as some of the biggest barriers to getting a penile implant. The first would be cost. Many men assume, before doing investigation, that they would have to pay cash for a penile implant. But in fact, a penile implant is a medical device which is FDA approved for the treatment of erectile dysfunction. Medicare and the VA consistently cover penile implants, and in fact, most commercial insurance plans do as well. Your physician's office can find out if your insurance plan covers this device. Of course, even if you have commercial insurance, you may have some financial responsibility, such as a copay or deductible. Our office works with patients all the time, and the majority are able to get coverage. The second barrier is procedure anxiety or that the implant seems strange. I will be the first to admit that many men do a double take the first time I show them a penile implant model. It seems like a lot of material, and men are concerned about placing something inside of them in this area. I might be concerned too if there weren't such a long history of placing these implants with great success. The penile implant was developed in the 1970s by Dr. Brantley Scott in Houston, Texas. Since that time, hundreds of thousands of implants have been placed, and approximately 30,000 are placed every year in the United States, with satisfaction rates that are very high. And most men will report that they wish they had undergone the procedure earlier. Many men report that the implant allows them to have spontaneous and natural feeling intercourse. Most of us have some fear and anxiety about undergoing medical procedures. Even as a physician, I know I myself have felt this anxiety. Yet the objective fact is, if you move beyond the fear, the majority of men are pleased with the outcome after having had a penile implant placed. And not only are the men satisfied, their partners are consistently satisfied as well. A third barrier is fear of complications. Any procedure can have complications. The most dreaded complication of a penile implant would be an infection. Your risk of infection depends on some of your particular risk factors. A risk factor which we are always aware of is diabetes. I work with men and their primary care doctor or endocrinologist to make sure their A1C is managed to an appropriate range to minimize their risk. Also, finding a surgeon with significant experience with penile implants increases your chance of having a good outcome. Finally, another barrier is concern about penile length and the belief that a penile implant will shorten the penis. So this seems to be a commonly held belief, and I want to explore it a little bit. So many men who have undergone a penile implant do so because they've had long-standing erectile dysfunction or Peyronie's disease. Peyronie's disease is a buildup of scar tissue in the penis and can cause penile shortening. Erectile dysfunction causes shortening of the penis, and we know that for every 18 months of ED, men lose about half a centimeter of penile length. So many men have already lost significant length by the time they have the penile implant placed, and for that reason, they believe that the implant shortened their penis. But in fact, it is the disease process that shortens the penis, not the penile implant. In fact, this is a reason to get the penile implant placed even earlier to avoid this shortening process, because once the penile implant is in place, the penis cannot shrink anymore. So a penile implant is a great option. We've reviewed some concerns, but most men who move beyond their concerns are satisfied with their outcome. I hope this content and video was helpful. If it was, please like and subscribe internal notifications so that you can see future content as it is released.